Hi, I'm Claire Bartel, and I'm a sales engineer here at Formlabs. Today, we're going to talk about taking supports off of your parts and sanding them so that they have a nice smooth surface finish. Supports are important for printability of parts as they're kind of building and curing onto the tank. They're going to help pull away that material. And we've done a lot of work on the software to make sure that those come off really cleanly, but you still need to sand them and post-process them. That kind of depends on the part and can vary in different ways. So we'll go through all of that today. To get started, before I take these parts off of their support structures, I will put on some safety goggles just in case those come and pop off. And I'll take a part here. You'll see the support structure at the bottom here. This is a raft, so you have a number of settings you can set for that. A lot of parts, what I like to do is just kind of press on the support structures to loosen them up, and then a lot of parts you can twist them and the support structure will come right off. For parts that are more delicate or are made out of tougher materials, sometimes I like to come in with a flush cutter and remove those support touch points without twisting. So something like this. On flexible materials or some delicate pieces, you can also use an X-Acto blade to remove these support touch points. So one thing that I like to do if I have a kind of a large raft is just break it up with the flush cutters so that I can easily get things off. So now that we've removed our support structures, it's time to sand down the nubs on these parts. We've done some work in the software to make sure that those nubs are going to be positive, so you can sand them down easily, but we'll use a number of the tools over here. So we have a couple different sandpapers. We have a coarser grit and a finer grit. Whenever we're sanding, we want to make sure that we're starting with a coarser grit, kind of get all of those large marks off the parts, and then move to a finer grit later just to kind of finish things up. We've also got water and some mineral oil here. So the water is going to help us wet sand. That'll help keep the dust down to a minimum. And then the mineral oil can help finish up the final part and make sure that it looks as best as it can. We'll start out by dry sanding this part. If your part requires a lot of sanding, we recommend you wear a face mask. So I've started with a fairly coarse sanding block, and I'm now going to move on to a finer grit sanding block. I have some water here, so I'll dump the part and then continue with a wet sanding method with a finer grit of sandpaper. And I'm gonna keep sanding with finer and finer sandpaper as I progress in the sanding process. Now that we've sanded the part, we have a couple options for finishing up our post-processing. We have a UV clear coat, so that's going to protect the part from UV and add a shine. We have plastics polish, and we also have mineral oil. So today, just to get a quick professional looking part, we are going to put some mineral oil on here. So we're just going to add a little bit of mineral oil to the surface, and then with either a microfiber cloth or a paper towel, you can just rub this in on the part. Another optional step, especially with clear parts to make them super clear, is to coat these parts in resin and then cure them. Thanks for joining us, and we hope these tips were helpful. Depending on your application, you may want to switch out some of these steps or experiment, but we hope this gives you a foundation for steps you can take to have professional looking parts and remove those support marks. Happy printing!